Sunbury. Proud tradition of a culture.
Stay off my focus.
If the Eclipse catches you here, you'll be lucky. Now we get to see if your attack on their focus network was entirely successful.
Uh-oh. You know Aloy is...
Welcome to the
interested in going down there.
I'll check back with you in a moment.
Outlander. In the meantime, if you want to hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room.
Let me just make sure I'm going the right way, because I did look up at a... I did look at a side quest, so... Just gotta make sure. It looks nice in here.
I hear the Shadow Carja are looking for one of their own. Should pay well.
By the glory of the sun revealed, behold, radiant Edomon, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of radiant Edomon does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little huntress. The green tent down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting.
Kind of busy.
Doing so, demonstrated wanton disregard for the safety.
We both know you're no killer for
subjects.
Hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel, gotta see the sun ring from on high.
Well, the Kestrels.
Ah, the balustrade.
They want us to see
it's a short drop from there.
It makes quite an impression.
Okay, here we go. I'm like, wait a minute, how do we get over there? Oh! Let's slow down. I'm moving a little too fast.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
Okay, we're looking for a vent. We're looking for a vent.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. No. It's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend into the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused.
Well,
no distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride.
Oh, I mean, I don't have enough pieces to get my super bow and arrows, so... It is what it is. I'm out of money.
I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels, only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure. As year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And voila. For her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identiscan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
I underestimated you. Except by now, I...
Guess you can't have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now, will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Aloy just keeps getting sassier and sassier. It's funny.
Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
I guess we're in Utah now.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostic. Detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this ring?
Please take a seat and wait for your name.
There's some stuff over here.
A selection of beverages and snacks are
available. We got audio logs, but...
smaller room.
Please proceed into viewing room one.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top-secret superweapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague, if Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a superweapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating, waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day, the day that life on Earth ceases to exist, is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris. Out.
That doesn't make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
This is interesting.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did.
You know what? I don't think we're too far from the time that happened. As you know how they believe in All Mother.
They got in through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place?
Well, yeah. If they believe in that All Mother thing, and it's obviously not All Mother, it's just all the computer stuff left behind from the old people, we might not be too far from when that extinction happened. They probably think that it's been a long time since the old ones roamed the earth, but I don't think that might be true.
I can pass them undetected.
The data points, you're going to ignore them?
Yep.
CD02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth Sobeck.
You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the re-flourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
The whole Earth destroyed. But then... remade?
Yes. By a machine. A machine of creation.
Intruder! Get her!
Whatever you do, don't die now.
Gotcha.
Quickly!
Come on. Come on, hit him. There we go. Nice, freaking bums. Those shock bombs really came in handy. Too bad they hurt me too, but whatever.
Another one of these. Need to find the right configuration.
Okay. Keep this up. Turn this way. Upside, down. Yeah, down. We gonna turn this. Oh wait, hold on. Side, up, side, down, up. To the side again.
Done. I should check the door nearby.
What is this? Let's get these two. Alright. Crap.
Maybe there's a storage area nearby.
Was this door open? Well, we got this door open. So maybe we don't even need to worry about that. I should have taken that big gun with me, to be honest. But I probably can't climb ladders and stuff like that, so.
Found one. Looks intact.
Is there anything else we need? I guess this is for down there. Can I make my arrows now? Still can't make my arrows. God damn.
That should do the trick. Now let's get that door. That did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
Okay, I got the door. Let's take one of these just in case.
Eclipse, they're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
Alright, so let's take out the fire arrow. I just want to have more than one fire arrow. You kidding me, dude? Look at that. Come on, I'm hitting you in your head.
No! You
cannot run.
Come on.
This is it for you.
I can't get this one guy's face. Okay, he's taken care of. Metal shards, exactly what I needed. Thank you. Not enough, I see. Let's scavenge this guy. There we go. Now these other guys can come. 1, 2. 3, 4, okay. I see them. Nope. That's not gonna work. That's not gonna work at all. They just don't stop moving. God damn. Every time I want to take aim at them, they just keep walking. I need them to stay still. I am not missing. Here we go. Bingo. This guy's not paying attention, though. I would like him to turn his head around. See, that's another thing. I don't, like, see them unless I'm inside the room. Fuck! Thank you. I'm not even gonna risk that. I don't see anybody. Let's crawl back to our little safe spot. See, now he wants to move. Like, come on. Oh, he sees me. Bingo. He's the last one up there. He's my only one I gotta deal with now. He's up there, so how am I supposed to take him out? Oh, you're mine. You're mine. More.
Or not.
Oh, gosh. We gotta go back in that room. Where's the room? Just in case. I am not playing with these guys. She's so white, I can't see their faces. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. I can't move. I'm stuck. I'm stuck. Oh man, I'm cornered.
Fear the power of the shadow.
I can't see. Pick it up. Pick it up. There we go. There we go.
For a moment, anyway.
Then get moving. You have to find Gaia.
We're bringing this gun out here. I ain't even playing no more.
You off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal fort.
I think this is it. Elizabeth Sobeck's office. But it's sealed off.
Until recently.
I am not playing with these guys no more. One, two, three. He gotta get taken out of there. Where is he? He's over there. Alright. I see you. Come on, man, why am I stuck in everything I try and touch? I really don't have ammo. Can't even see the head. Oh.
Get out of the way and find cover!
Bingo, bingo. Hitting in his face.
Nope.
There we go. All right, we're going to continue on the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. Peace.